I'm so excited to talk about microbiomes.
Oh, gross. I think I'll do this one by myself. You and your microbial cloud, get out of here.
Okay.
Gross people. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Bacteria is everywhere, literally, in the ground, on the subway, in and on your body. I mean, we are mostly made up of bacteria. There's more of them than there are of us. For every one of our cells, there's 10 bacterial cells. The most bacteria in the body can be found in the gut, which isn't all that surprising. There's been a lot of research lately on the microbiome, the ecosystem of bacteria that lives in and on us. One small study published in the journal Science found that other bacteria-laden areas of the body include your palms, behind your knees, and your feet. But the most diversity on your body, that can be found on your forearms. Weird, right? But it's not just in and on our bodies, it's around our bodies. We literally walk with a cloud of bacteria everywhere we go, kind of like Pigpen from Peanuts. In a study published in the journal PeerJ, researchers captured air surrounding participants. They had people sit in boxes for 4 hours and measured the air around them. They found they could identify thousands of types of bacterial DNA and could tell whether the person was male or female just by the air around them. So basically, you can get someone else's microbiomes even when you're just standing next to them. Great, that's gonna make commutes awkward. So once that bacteria leaves us, where does it go? Well, the most bacteria-laden places tend to be places like public transit. One really cool study of recent years was a massive undertaking by researchers at Weill Cornell Medical College. They swabbed thousands and thousands of surfaces of the New York City subway system, a system that sees nearly 5.5 million people per day passing through its stations and trains. Their findings were published in the journal Cell Systems. In total, they found DNA from more than 15,000 different life forms. Almost half of the DNA belonged to bacteria. But I should say that most of the bacteria they found is harmless. Only 12% were linked to any kind of disease. But it's not just in public, it's at home too. There's millions and millions of microbes in nearly every nook and cranny of our homes. And one study published in the journal Science analyzed the homes of 7 families over the course of a few weeks, and they found something surprising. The people seemed to make the bacteria. Like when 3 of the families moved, it only took 1 day for their new house to look like their old house, microbially at least. And bathrooms, man, bathrooms. Bathrooms are pretty gross, but not as gross as you'd think. Turns out your bathroom is dominated by bacteria from your skin. Yeah, not exactly what you'd expect. Yeah, bacteria from your bum like Roseburia and bacteria from other nether regions like Lactobacillus and Enterococcus are present in restrooms, but only briefly. Bathrooms are too cold, too dry, and too oxygen-rich to support growth of these kinds of bacteria. Instead, 68 to 98% of the bacteria the researchers found came from skin and from the outdoors. So the germiest place in your home isn't the toilet. One study published in the Journal of Applied Microbiology found that it's in the kitchen, especially the areas that remain moist, like the kitchen sink, which gets touched a lot. The study found that the sink can have nearly 100,000 bacteria per centimeter, where the toilet only has about 100. And let's not even mention the dish sponge. Ugh, they have the highest concentration of bacteria of any place in the home. Gross. But bacteria gets a bad rap. It's not all bad. In fact, some of it's pretty good for us. Research shows that being exposed to more bacteria actually bolsters our immune systems. Seriously, there's ideas out there that say we're actually too clean in our environments, leading to modern diseases like asthma. And it's just as much a part of us as anything else. So while if I were you, I'd toss out that dish sponge right now, a fine balance of bacteria seems to be just what the doctor ordered. But the dish sponge isn't the only thing that's covered in bacteria. Your cell phone is pretty freaking gross. Check out how gross in this episode right here.
82% of the most common bacteria found on the subject's fingers were also present on their phones, meaning your personal microbiome, which is the specific collection of bacteria that's unique to every person, closely resembles the bacteria on your phone.
So how grossed out are you right now? Tell us down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.